Chicago.
Hello, welcome to OLT 322, African American Literature, Lecture 8 on Richard Wright and Native Son. Today we're going to talk about how the book is broken into three sections. We're going to talk about the question of identity, and then we're going to talk about imagery and symbolism. The novel Native Son is divided into three parts. The first part is about Bigger's fears. Bigger is the main character, of course, and his fears revolve around his fear of authority, his fear of whites, and his fear of poverty. His fear leads to hatred and to false displays of courage to hide his fear. His fear of whites come from that Jim Crow wisdom which we've talked about, where blacks are supposed to behave a certain way when they're around whites. And this informs his relationship with Mary. He gets a job with a rich man called Mr. Dalton, and he has a daughter, Mary. Mary tries to treat him differently with her friend Jan, who is in the Communist Party. They try to show him that they are different. They're not like other white people. But Bigger fears this because it can cause him trouble from other whites. You know, that they'll blame him rather than the white people. They'll blame him for acting out of his place and get him in big trouble. So he fears this. He also doesn't trust their motives. He thinks maybe they're trying to make fun of him or something like that. And in the end, he kills her out of fear. Book two is about his escape. He's running for his life. This physical journey coincides with also an emotional and mental journey. He awakens his self-consciousness, his dignity, and his identity. When he starts to accept responsibility for killing Mary, he has a sense of his own power. The murder also represents an attack on the forces which oppress him. In a sense, he is fighting back, and we've seen that before. He murders Bessie out of fear, but also as proof of his own existence, as someone who can do things, who can act. Book three is about his fate. It shows all the forces that have shaped him: family, authority, whites, blacks, society, and shows how different elements have tried to exploit him when he's in jail. Politicians, the church, the Communist Party. Max is the only one to try to help him selflessly. And it shows Bigger that some people are not bad. Some people are good, and it helps him to return from his animal-like state. Now we're going to talk about identity. Bigger suffering from an identity which is forced upon him by society, that he's a poor black man, and certain things are expected of him and other things are not. He has no power to change it. He is also frustrated by his poverty and his helplessness. And his frustrations and fear, they alienate him, and he acts tough to hide his fear. He's stuck between the white and black world because he cannot change his life due to the powers keeping him down, and because he cannot adapt to the life which he lives as his family has done. Killing Mary is a move to self-identification through action. If you are what you do, then he has gone from being nothing to being something. Through his own actions, his own power, he's defined himself. A murderer, yes, but it was his own actions. This is self-definition, and this self-definition gives him a sense of self and of power, which he never had before. Also, he goes from being an invisible man, an invisible black man, just another face in the crowd. He's forced white people to see him. He is somebody. They have to consider him and take him into account. To account for him. Through defining himself, he stops his self-hatred and his hatred of others also. Imagery and symbolism. There are two main symbols and images in the novel. One is that of the rat, which is a symbol of poverty. We see it in the house. And Bigger kills it and uses it to scare his sister. And it's also then a symbol of his tendency of reacting to fear with violence. Blindness is an even bigger symbol. Bigger blinds himself to the truth of his reality through violent fantasies, which he then tries to live. His own racism blinds him to to the humanity of other whites who want to help him. The blindness of whites to the humanity of blacks generally is an oppressive force, and it's represented by the blindness of Mary's mother. Another thing is, after he commits the murder, at first the white people, they can't even imagine that a black man could do that murder, that he could commit the crime and be clever enough to hide the body the way that he has done. So they're blind to the power of one person who happens to be black. They don't see the possibility in him. The black community also has its own blindness by escaping into alcoholism, religious fanaticism, and narrow nationalism. Now I'm going to read the conclusion from the course material. In conclusion, it can be said that in bigger, Wright has taken the black's condition head-on by describing a character in the extreme. Bigger is so alienated from traditional values, restraints, and civilized modes of behavior that he feels free to construct his own ethics. For him, an act of murder is an act of creation. Now, this is a strong statement. It's an extreme, but it illustrates the effects of racist oppression. There could be other ways of identifying oneself, but when you're left with almost nothing, then what can you do? How many choices have you got? And often, as we've seen, as with Frederick Douglass, the first step towards defining yourself, towards creating a new reality, is some kind of violence, or violent change. Of course, with Bigger, it was completely negative because he murdered somebody, an innocent person. And whereas with Frederick Douglass, he fought and beat up the slave master who was abusing him. This is Warren Reed with OLT 322, Lecture 8. I hope this has helped clarify some things. And if you have any questions, don't forget you can email me. Don't forget you have Moodle. There's plenty of things on the Moodle. And I wish you the best of luck with your studies. And if you can, try to read the novels. This novel is very, very interesting. You'll enjoy it. California to my sweet home, Chicago.